So have you ever seen a parent or a spouse who wasn't able to connect well with their family? Have you ever seen a coworker or a boss who wasn't able to connect well with their team? Why is that? Why aren't they able to connect well? Well, there is a very well-known Christian counselor named Dr. Henry Cloud, and he's helped literally thousands of marriage couples work through their conflicts and issues. He's worked with numerous business leaders and teams, helping them work through work-related conflicts. And somebody asked Dr. Cloud, they said, "Dr. Cloud, what is, in your experience, the number one thing you've seen that has kept people from resolving their conflicts?" And he paused for a second and he said, "By far, the number one thing lacking in a relationship when people are in a conflict is empathy." Empathy. Empathetically communicating with the person you're disagreeing with or having a conflict with. Lack of empathetic communication is what keeps husbands and wives not connecting well in resolving conflicts. Lack of empathetic communication keeps fathers distanced emotionally from their kids and vice versa. Mothers towards kids. Empathy is what's lacking in most workplace issues. It's a lack of empathetic communication. So what in the world is empathy? Take a look up on the screen. Empathy is when you're talking to somebody and you're trying to understand their feelings and thoughts and their experiences, and then you try to express that understanding in a way that the person feels, here it is, watch this, they feel heard and understood. So in other words, if I'm going to be empathetically listening, when somebody is upset, I'm going to try to put myself in their shoes. I'm going to try to literally feel what they're feeling. I'm going to try to experience what they are experiencing. And you know who did a great job of this in the Bible? Jesus. You will see as you read about Jesus numerous examples where he empathetically connected with people. Let me give you one example. There was a time when he was coming to a funeral for a dear friend named Lazarus. There was heaps of people that were around Lazarus's tomb. He'd been buried there for a few days. Everybody's mourning, they're crying. And we see that when Jesus came to this funeral, listen to this. Even though he knew he was going to raise Lazarus from the dead in a few days, it says that he wept. In fact, the shortest verse in the Bible is Jesus wept. And where did Jesus weep? At a funeral, because other people were weeping. Now stop and think about that. He knew that Lazarus was going to come back to life. He had no reason to weep. So why did he weep? Because he chose to empathize with them. Listen, he chose to feel what they were feeling. He chose to mourn when they were mourning, to cry when they were crying. And if you want to resolve conflicts, I'm telling you, this is huge. You and I, we have to empathize. We have to try to understand what they're feeling. We have to try to see things from their perspective. Take a look at this verse up on the screen. It says in Romans 12, 15, "Rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who are weeping." In other words, when you're with people, you want a close connection with people, you want to be godly, you want to be like Jesus, then be happy with those who are happy, and then cry when you're with others who are crying. When you're in a conflict with somebody, you need to ask yourself, man, what are they feeling? What are you feeling? Help me understand that. And then try to experience the feelings they're feeling. And when you do that, I'm telling you, it is a game changer. I was thinking about my own marriage, and I was thinking about the turning points in the conflicts that my wife and I were having years ago. We would just go round and round in circles of conflict. And it wasn't until I started to really try to put myself in her shoes that things started to change. In fact, to this day, if we ever get in a conflict, often the turning point in that conflict is when I really try to understand where she's coming from, where I try to feel the hurt that she's feeling, or the frustration that she's feeling, where I try to understand that and admit my part within that. If you aren't doing that already, can I tell you, parents, coaches, business leaders, coworkers, we all need to work at being empathetically communicating, because you know what? It is completely unnatural to do it. Our focus is more on ourselves than the other. And that's why when we get in conflicts, we're more interested in blaming than empathizing. We're more interested in defending than putting ourselves in their shoes for a few moments. So let's be people who are like Jesus, who empathetically listen and feel and try to understand what people are feeling. And when we feel that, then it's easier to communicate to the other person. I heard you, and I understand as best as I can. And when we do that, it's powerful at bringing people together.